Assalamu alaikum students, how are you all? I hope that you all are fine. Welcome to the channel Maths D1 D2 Scientific Academy. And today our lecture is related to chapter 3, which is basic algebra and algebraic manipulation. In new book it's chapter 3, but in old book it's chapter 4. And your book is new syllabus mathematics 1. And we are going to do practice now, which is given on page number 69. In new book it's page 69, but in old book it's page 90. Okay ji, before starting the lecture I would request you that if you like these videos and if you want more help regarding your subject, kindly subscribe the channel. Okay ji, let's come to the lecture and practice now. To question number 1 is simplify each of the following expressions. Here you can see the question which is given. Simplify each of the following expression. Five expressions are given in which you have to simplify them. And then second question is simplify the expression again. Second question is different. And part 2 is find the value of the expression when p is equal to 1 by 2, q is equal to minus 1 by 3 and r is equal to 4. So these are the question and I'm going to explain you these questions. Okay ji. Part A is 2x minus 5y. Question number 1 of practice now 2. And part A, 2x minus 5y plus 4y and plus 8x. Okay students, remember that whenever you are having the expression like this in which you are having different variables, so what you need to do is you have to solve the like terms together. Okay, let me explain to you what are like terms. Like terms are those terms which are having the same variables. Here you can see that this is x term and this is also x term. Both coefficients are having the same variables. This is x and this is also x. So these are the like terms. And here you can see that 5y and 4y, these both terms are having the same variable. This is y and this is also y. So these two are the like terms. 2x and x are the like terms and 5y and 4y are the like terms. You can just solve the like terms together. You cannot solve unlike terms together. And what are unlike terms? For example, if you are having x variable with one coefficient but different variable with the other coefficient. Here you can see that. So these are the different. This is x and this is y. Variables are different. So these are not like terms. We will say that these are the unlike terms. So you have to solve the like terms together. And you can solve. You cannot solve unlike terms. So what is the first step? The first step is you have to write the like terms together. So 2x and 8x, these both are the like terms. So write them together with signs. Don't forget to write the sign with the term. Now this is minus. Now write the y terms. This is minus 5y and plus 4y. You will solve these two together. These are the like terms. Plus plus is plus, and when you will add 2 and 8, you will get 10. 8, 9, 10. 10x. Minus 5y plus 4y. When you will subtract 4 from 5, you will get y. You will get just 1y. Remember that there is no need to write 1 as a coefficient with the variable. A single variable means it has one coefficient. So 5 minus 4 is 1, 1y. So instead of writing 1y, I will just write y. And you have to write the sign of the bigger number. The bigger number is 5. So I'll put minus sign over here. So this is the sign of the bigger number. So I have put minus sign. Minus y. So this is your answer. I hope that this is clear to you. Now let's come to the B part. Okay, GB part is 11x minus minus 5y minus 14x and minus 2y. Here you can see that these two signs are coming together. So wherever the two signs are coming together, the very first step is multiply those signs. So this is 11x minus and minus. When you will multiply minus with minus, you will get plus. Minus and minus plus 5y. Now write the rest of the things as it is, as they are. Okay, now write the like terms together. This is x term and this is x term. So these are the like terms. Write them together. 11x minus 14x. And this y term, 5y, and this y term. These are the like terms. So write them together. Plus 5y and minus 2y. What I did is, I have written the like terms together. Plus 5y minus 2y. Alright. Now next step is solve them. With 11 it's plus sign, so plus minus is minus. What you need to do is you have to do the operation of subtraction. Subtract 11 from 14, you will get 3. 3x. You have to write the sign of the bigger number. The bigger number is 14, and with 14 it's minus sign. So write minus sign. Now solve 5y and 2y. You solve these two terms. And plus minus is minus. It means that you will do the operation of subtraction. You will subtract 2 from 5. You will get 3y. And you have to write the sign of the bigger number, which is plus. So you will write plus 5 minus 2 is 3y. So this is your answer of the B part. I hope that this is clear to you. Alright, now let's come to the C part. Okay, the C part is minus 9x minus minus y plus minus 3x minus 7y. So the very first step is you have to multiply the signs which are coming together. So these two signs are coming together, multiply them. So minus minus is plus y. Plus minus is minus 3x and minus 7y. I have multiplied the sign which are coming together. I have multiplied these two signs and I got plus. And I multiplied plus and minus and I got minus. Okay, the next step is write like terms together. This is the x term and this is the x term. So these two are the like terms. Write them together. Minus 9x minus 3x. And this y term and this y term. These two are the like terms. Write them together. That is plus y and minus 7y. Don't forget to write the sign of the terms. Okay, now solve the like terms together. These two are the like terms. See, both are having minus sign, minus and minus plus. So you have to do the operation of addition. When you will add 3, 9, you will get 9, 10, 11, 12. You have to write the sign of the bigger number, which is minus. So you write minus 12x. You have to write the variable which is given. Now you will solve these two like terms. Plus minus is minus, so you will subtract 1 from 7. Remember that here there is no coefficient. So when there is no coefficient, it means that the coefficient over there is 1. When there is no coefficient with the variable, the coefficient over there is 1. So it means that you have to subtract 1 from 7 and then you will get 6y. You have to write the sign of the bigger number, which is minus. So you write minus 6y. So this is the answer of C part. Okay, in this question here, you can see that we are having fractions. So remember that whenever we are having fractions and in between it's plus or minus sign, so we have to take the LCM. So what you will do is you will take the LCM of 2 and 3. So when I will take the LCM of 2 and 3, take the LCM of the denominators. The denominators are 2 and 3. So I'm going to take the LCM of 2 and 3. 2 ones are 2 and 3 ones are 3. So the LCM would be 6. 2 threes are 6. Okay, see the denominators here, it is 2. Which time 2 is 6? It's 3 times, so I'll multiply the numerator with 3. 2 3s are 6. And here the denominator is 3. Which time 3 is 6? It's 2 times, so I'll multiply the numerator with 2. 3 2s are 6. 2 3s are 6. The other method is you can make the denominators and numerators same. Okay, what you will do now is you'll multiply the numerators. 3 1s are 3x and minus 2 1s are 2x. Now solve it. 3x minus 2x. 3 minus 2 is 1x. So there is no need to write 1 as a coefficient with the variable. So you will just write x. So x over 6 is the answer. Or we can say that, okay, we can write like this. 3 minus 2 is 1. 1 by 6, and I can write the variable like this. 1 by 6x. I hope that this is clear to you. Okay, now let's come to E part. Okay, E part is 7 by 4y minus 5 by 8y. Again, we are having fractions. So whenever we are having fractions, we have to take the LCM. So I will take the LCM of 4 and 8. 2 2s are 4, 2 4s are 8, 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, and 2 1s are 2. When I will multiply these, I will get 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8. It means that LCM is 8. So you will write 8. Now see the denominators, which term 4 is 8, it's 2 times, so multiply the numerator with 2. 4 2's are 8, and which term 8 is 8, it's 1 times, so multiply the numerator with 1. 8 1's are 8. Now multiply the numerators, 2 7's are 14y, minus 5 1's are 5y. When you will subtract 5 from 14, you will get 9. Yes, it's 9. So 9 over 8y. Here you can see that this is improper fraction. So you can convert it into the whole number. When you will divide 9 with 8, you will get 1 whole 1 by 8 y. So this is your answer. I hope that this is clear to you. Okay, first question is done. Now I'm going to explain you question number 2 of practice now too. And part 1 is, here you can see that an expression is given. We have to simplify this expression. Here there are different variables are given. This P variable is given, Q variable is given, and R variable is given. So what you need to do is you can just solve the like terms together. So the very first step is write like terms together. This is P term and this is P term. So write these two terms together. These are the like terms. 2P minus 4P. Don't forget to write the sign of that term. Now this is 5Q and this is 2Q. These two are the like terms. So write them together. Minus 5Q plus 2Q. This 7R and 3R, these two are the like terms. So write them together. Plus 7R minus 3R. Now solve it. Solve these two terms. These are the like terms. Plus minus is minus. So what you will do is you will do subtraction. When you will subtract 2 from 4, you will get 2P. You have to write the sign of the bigger number. So the sign of the bigger number is minus. Now solve these two terms. These two are the like terms. Plus minus is minus. So you will subtract 2 from 5. When you will subtract 2 from 5, you will get 3. You have to write the sign of the bigger number, which is minus. So minus 3Q. Now solve these two terms together, the last two terms. Plus minus is minus, it means you will do the subtraction. Subtract 3 from 7, that you will get 4. You have to write the sign of the bigger number, which is plus. So plus 4. So this is your answer. Question number 2, part 2 is related to this. They are saying that find the value of the expression when P is equal to 1 by 2, Q is equal to minus 1 by 3, and R is equal to 4. So what you need to do is write down, I'm going to do part 2. Remember this expression which we have solved. Now the values are given. P is equal to 1 by 2, Q is equal to minus 1 by 3, and R is equal to 4. Put these value in this main expression which you have found in part 1. So minus 2P, write this expression again. Minus 3Q plus 4R. Now put the values. Minus 2. So P is 1 by 2. Write 1 by 2. Minus 3Q. So minus 3Q is minus 1 by 3. So write minus 1 by 3 instead of this Q. I have put the value of P. So I have written 1 by 2 instead of this P. I have put the value of Q, so I have written minus 1 by 3 instead of this Q. Now it's the next is plus 4R. Plus 4 and R is 4, write 4 over here instead of this R. Now solve it. This 2 and this 2 will cut each other because this 2 is dividing with this 2 and this 3 is dividing with this 3. Cut this 3 with this 3. You are left with minus 1. And now these two signs are coming together, multiply them, minus and minus. Plus 1 and plus 4 4s are 16. Solve from left to right, minus and plus. Minus 1 minus 1 is 0. So 0 plus 16 is 16. So your answer is 16. 16 is your answer. I hope that you are clear till here. And thank you very much. Take a very good care of yourself. And Allah Hafiz.